Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mark and I'm the Mediocre Modeler. And I'm bringing smiles to people's faces, one model at a time. I want to thank all my subscribers and all the kind words and comments. I really appreciate each and every one of you. So this is the second update on the USAC 2023 group build. And this is going to be my take on it. 1955 Frankenford. So, the bed panels are in primer. And you see these lines on the panels, on the side of the panels. Well, that's where the fender's going. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use tape to mask it off. And I'm going to paint it with Rust-Oleum flat black primer. And then I'll hit it with a matte clear. And then the rest of the panel is going to be shot with body color. I have to sand this pin mark off. That I should have did it before. But anyways, I'll do that. And so that's going to be a two-tone. And most of this build is going to be, for me, is going to be masking things off and, honing my skills on that. But let's move on to the next thing. So, I forgot the steering wheel. So, I got to probably hit this with a chrome pen. I probably should have stripped it, but anyways, I'll hit it with a chrome pen, and then I got to put the steering wheel on and paint that, and so anyways, I haven't done that yet. I want to light this kit, so I didn't really know where to get the lights, and I subscribe to a bunch of people on YouTube, and one of the guys that I'm subscribed to, he just finished a Texaco truck, and his site is Grandpa Mark's Hobbies, and he has links in that video of it's the final reveal of the Texaco truck. And he has links in the description to a lot of different things. And one of the things that I needed was the micro lights. I wanted to try to light a kit, so I'm going to try to light this kit. So I used the link in his description, and I bought this micro LED. They came in a pack of 20 for like 10 bucks. And then I bought some batteries. And let's see if I can get this thing going on film here. But it's pretty amazing, you know. So this is the first time I ever light a kit. And it's going to be pretty fun. This is going to be the headlights. There you go. So, also with the kit, not the kit, but part of this lighting thing is this little controller. So you slide the battery in here, then you have a little on-off switch, and you can solder positive and negative here, positive and negative here. I think Mark was saying that you can run up to 8 lights with this. So if you wanted to do a low rider and light up the underneath of the chassis, you could do 8 lights, 4 on each side. That'd be pretty cool. I might try that on my low rider group build hosted by Leon. Model car 1589. So yeah, I went to Mark's website, not website, YouTube channel, and he had a link in the description, so I bought a bunch of those, and I'm going to light this kit. It's going to be pretty neat. Well, now that I know that I'm going to light this kit, I have to figure out how to hide this. So, obviously, I'm going to have to put it in the back, in the bed. So, I was thinking, Frankenford, what would go good in the back of this Frankenford? So, I went to my local hobby shop and I bought these stick stirrers. There are 50 of them for like, I think they were like $2 or maybe a dollar. But I came up with Dracula's coffin. I cracked myself up. So anyways, this is going to go on the back. And I can put the controller in here. And I put the cover on the coffin. Dracula's coffin on the Frankenford. The only problem. So, you ever hear that saying? Measure twice, cut once. Well, I measured once. Now I'm going to have to cut twice. Because when I did the measurement, I took the inside from here to here. So when I put the sticks on the outside here, I added about 2 millimeters more. So now it doesn't fit. So I got a choice to make. Hey, Sully, stay. I got a choice to make. Either I'm going to make another casket, or I'm going to make this into a steak body. Get it? Dracula, steak, body. What I was thinking, I got some brass rod coming. I ordered some mahogany and some maple wood. Because old Tom's video, one of his videos, it was the Chevy truck. And his bed he did with mahogany and maple. And in between was the brass. So you had mahogany, brass, maple, brass, mahogany, brass, and came out awesome. So I'm going to do that for the base here. And if I use the brass rods coming up over here, like three brass rods and then a little chain coming between, that would be pretty cool. That way you could see, you know, the casket. Or, you know, like I said, I'll just make another casket, and then I'll use this on next year's Halloween group build. But that came out pretty cool. I like the way it came out. So the body of the truck's in primer. I used, Mr. Surfacer 1200. And what a nice primer. Lays down real flat, smooth. I saw a lot of the videos, people had issues of bad gaps and stuff. I think mine's pretty good. I lucked out, you know. It's not too bad. I'm happy with it. So I'm going to do this in two different colors, but I'm not going to reveal them right now. That'll be saved for the final reveal. But I'll tell you, I'm having the time of my life. I really appreciate all my subscribers and everybody who checks out my videos and comments. You know, I appreciate it. I really do. I enjoy it. You know, it's just a great community. So there you have it. This is my first update on the USAC group build. A lot of fun. I want to thank everybody for joining me on this video. And please give me a like and a subscribe. And leave a comment. I appreciate everybody's support. Thank you. Peace out.